गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट द क्वांटिटी कैलकुलेशन ऑफ आरसीसी स्लैब कल्वर्ट। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द एथर एक्सहिबिशन सीमेंट कॉन्क्रीट एंड सम पार्ट ऑफ फर्स्ट क्लास ब्रिकवर्क। ओके, we already discussed abutment section and finger section of first class brickwork. Today class we discuss the parapet wall. First of all, we know about what do you mean by parapet up to curve and parapet above curve. Parapet up to curve means, here the diagram we can see here, parapet up to curve means from this part, from the end of the slab to this part, so this is our curve. From this point to this point, 20 centimeters or 10 centimeters thick distance from this point to this point, parapet up to curve. Then parapet above curve means from curve to this point, parapet above curve. Then our word parapet coping. Okay, here the coping section, here the coping section, here from this point to this point, parapet up to curve. From this point to this point, parapet above curve. Then here the coping. So first of all, to define the breadth and height, we follow the CBEF section or half longitudinal section on CBEF. Then you define the length of the parapet. We can consider the ABCD section. Okay. Or otherwise, by normally the parapet lies on this area, top lies on the total width of the abutment. Okay, from this person, it means the length of the parapet is 4.80 equal to the abutment. Okay, length of the parapet equal to the length of the abutment. Okay, so let me discuss parapet up to curve. Parapet up to curve, two numbers. Parapet above curve, also two numbers. Parapet coping, also two numbers. Parapet lies on the top of the abutment. Okay, so abutment two numbers means parapet also have two numbers. Okay, then parapet, how could I define the parapet length? First of all, here the details of the parapet section is showing. In this section, the overall view of the parapet section is given. Overall length with coping is, length is 4.90. okay, after reducing the 10% offset this side and 10% offset this from this side, we can calculate the total length of the parapet section. Parapet lies on the above the abutment. Okay, so we can define the parapet section height or parapet section length from this part. Here the total length of total length of parapet is defined from this part. Okay, this is your roadway. Okay, here the details diagram of parapet, how the parapet lies on the section. here the total area covered by the parapet. Here the total area covered by the parapet. Okay, here also a parapet. This is the road area which we can use for the transportation purpose, or then the total length from this point, to this point, we have to consider the length of the parapet. Okay, so first of all, we know total length of the overall coping is 4.90. So first layer of the topmost layer of the parapet is coping. Okay, the coping is total given here 4.90. From here offset 10 cm. From here also 10 offset 10 cm. We can deduct the 4.90 meter minus 0.10 meter, and this side also 0.10 meter. Then we can define the distance between this point to this point. Okay, so this point, then the length of the total parapet. Okay, so 4.90 minus 10 centimeters could be how many meter? 0.10 meter. Here also same offset 0.10 meter. 4.90 minus 0.10 minus 0.10. The total length is 4.70. Okay, the length of the parapet we define by using this diagram. Okay, next, first we going through the length of the parapet. Parapet up to curve, two numbers 4.70. Parapet above curve, also two numbers 4.70 length. Okay, then we going through the breadth part of parapet up to curve and parapet above curve. Okay, here parapet up to curve, first I discuss here two width provided for the parapet. One is 40 cm, one is 30 cm. From this point we consider parapet up to curve. It means from this ending of the slab to the end of the 40 cm wall, we consider the height of the parapet up to curve distance. Okay, so breadth of the parapet is 40. Parapet above curve, breadth of the parapet is 30. One parapet up to curve, breadth of the parapet is 40, above is 30. First, see here, parapet up to curve, breadth of the parapet is 40, above curve, breadth of the parapet is 30. Okay, next, we define the height of parapet up to curve and parapet above curve. Here, the diagram represents the curve section cannot enter the 40 cm wall, or curve is provided between the two parapet. Okay, between the two parapet, but the slab section enter with the 40 cm wall. So from end of the slab section to this point, we define the height of the parapet up to curve. Okay, it means the curve section is 10 cm thick plus this height is 20. 10 plus 20 is total height is 30. Parapet up to curve height is 30. Okay, then parapet above curve. Parapet above curve height is how much? With coping 60, coping thickness is 10 cm. So 60 minus 10. So without coping, parapet above curve height is 50. Okay, total coping with curve, coping with parapet, total height is 60. When we deduct the coping height thickness, then the height of the parapet is 50. Okay, here the details. Height of the parapet is up to curve 30, above is 0.50. Okay, then we going to the parapet coping. Parapet two numbers means coping also two numbers. So coping is two numbers. Then length of the coping, how can we define from the half sectional elevation here? Because the parapet lying from this point to this point, the coping length is here totally given 4.90. Then, but breadth of the coping, what is the breadth of the coping? How can we find out? By using the longitudinal sectional elevation here, given the breadth of the coping is 40 cm. Okay. Then, thickness of the coping is 0.10. Already we discussed about. Here, showing here, 10 cm thickness. This person is your coping. Okay. Then, we define the quantity. How can we define the quantity? Number into length into breadth into thickness. Then we define the quantity. Then total quantity we can define. Okay. Thank you. Next part we discuss in next class.